All right, Shalom. First off, I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rekha Kodas. I want to give double honors to the pastors and elders, a great millstone, a peace of salutation to the elect. This is Ashawn coming at you once again from the Baltimore Brent. And I wanted to go, this is a part of the last video that I did. I went in depth on Matthew, the 18th chapter, right? So, on this, video, I want to go in depth on the 19th chapter, and we're going to start at, around at 16, and we're going to go in a little in depth, because this was Yahweh Shah. He was talking about the kingdom, right? As I stated before in the last video. This is sort of like a second part series of the last video I did on Matthew, going in depth on Matthew, the 18th chapter. But only this is part two on going in on the 19th chapter. And, you know, this is to edify the body, the elect, because, you know, brothers be going through hell. You know, that's what we supposed to go through, you know. In order to, you know, get the kingdom, you know, we got to go through the fire, you know. This, the Lord wanted us to, you know right and wrong. How would we know how it is to go through the fire if we ain't never been in it, you know? And, you know, a lot of things on this side, brothers might get depressed and things like that, anxiety, you know. A brother might, and we all go through this, you know, we go through, stages and, sort of say, dry spells or where as though we might not have a woman at the time or might not get any in at the time. And these are all things, these necessities that think, we need to, you know, survive. I mean, if Jake go a long time without a woman, he go crazy, you know? I've been there, I've done that, been there, went a long time without a woman, you know, because we got to understand, we got to be more spiritual dealing with this truth. And a lot of, living in this society, in this system of things, this is like this is a queendom. You got to tend to the woman a lot, you know, and a woman, got a lot of authority in this kingdom, and you got to cater to them. It should be the opposite way around, because everything is upside down, we know, and you got to basically be a simp to have a girlfriend now these days. And none of these brothers that's in the truth are simps, you know, I will hope, because Yahweh Shah was not a simp when he came on earth in that incarnation, you know. He wasn't a simp, you know. I mean, I know brothers, you know, been simps in the past because we ain't know no better. But once you learn the truth, you're supposed to come up out of that, you know. And we gonna forsake a lot of things, you know. Like I myself, I forsake having women and girlfriends and... Because they're not going to see eye to eye with you doing this truth, you know. But let's go in depth, you know. This is Matthew chapter 19, and we're going to start at verse 16. The title is The Rich Young Man. But any old way, it reads, "And behold, one came and said unto him, Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And he said unto him," this was Yahweh Shah speaking to one of the disciples. He's reading on. "Why callest thou me good?" Right? Reading on, he says, "There is no good but one, and that is Yahweh." So, okay, "but if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments." So the Lord, the God, let's read it over. It says, "Behold, one came..." Talking about the disciples, "one came and said unto him, Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And so he called Yahawashah good master. And Yahawashah said unto him, why callest thou me good? So Yahawashah said, why you call me good? He said, I ain't good. He said, the only one that's good is my father, Yahawah. So we know that that's a humbling experience right there, because if Yahawashah called himself, if Yahawashah said he wasn't good, then we know for damn sure we ain't good, you know, because we all sin, you know, we all fall short of the glory, you know, so none of us are none of us should be walking around proud, you know. All of us should have a humble, somewhat of a attitude, you know. Cause ain't none of us good, you know. So we all have to beg Yahawah and His Son for mercy, you know. Okay, reading on, it says, he said, keep the commandments. He said, he saith unto him, which Yahawashah said, thou shalt do no murder. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Right, so don't kill nobody. Murder meaning unrighteous killing. Thou shalt not commit adultery, you know, sleeping with another man's wife. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness, lying on someone. Honor thy father and thy mother. So you got to honor your parents, you know. And some of you Jake, man, some of you Jake don't honor your father, man. You know, and, you know, some of our parents had did wicked things, but that's still your parents, no matter what, you know. I was fortunate enough to, you know, grow up with a father, but he had passed a year back, you know, and I miss him dearly, you know, and, man, it's a blessing to have a father, man. And a lot of you, Jake, y'all disrespect your father, man. And the only reason that most likely your father had, you know, wasn't in contact with you, or, you know, didn't probably raise you around, is because of your mother. You know, these women are wicked, man. They took the sides of the government, you know. And if you're in His truth, you should already know about how the so-called black woman took the side of the government in the 60s and the 70s. And before that, in slavery, you know. And we can go all the way back to the garden, you know. They made that pact with the devil. They made that pact with Satan. Eve made that pact with Satan. But all through world history, they just repeated the process. Like, they sold out to Satan. The most recent time they sold out to Satan was this feminist movement with this Me Too, all this bullshit. But around prior to that, it was in the 60s where the so-called white man Esau had made a thing to split the had came up with a plan to separate the families, and he used the black woman to do it. He used the black woman as a pawn, you know. So, like we say, the black woman is, you know, the enemy to the black man and on that side, because, you know, it's they just wicked, man. If you look at the things they set up to do, you look at how they don't respect us or anything, you would know. You being in the truth, man. And you got some sisters out there that has that's for the good cause. But it's enough with saying, oh, it ain't all. Man, the majority of these women are off, man. The majority of them are off. It's more than a little. Put it like that, you know. All right, it says, honor your mother and your father. Honor your mother, too, you know. Like we, well, Jake ain't got no problem with that, you know. Jake, you know, Jake loves his mother, you know. Actually, they love their mother more than their father, you know. But that's why the scripture is right here. Honor thy father and thy mother. And you see it say father first. You're supposed to honor your father, man. A lot of y'all got that woman spirit on you. You grew up around your mother coming up, and you think that's how the way they're supposed to act. All emotional, getting mad all of a sudden, thinking you can yell at people and thinking ain't no react. Oh, they're going to react to you quicker because you're a man. You know, women can get away with that. That's the thing, they don't raise you. They don't raise you up to understand that. See, if you had a father, your father would tell you otherwise. You know, he would tell you the real. You know, when he discipline you, he'll discipline you right. He wouldn't discipline you out of anger and emotion, you know. That's why you have a lot of guys out here. They kill. That's how they grow up. They get a certain age and they hate black men themselves. They hate black men just like their mother. That's why all these killings going on. Whenever you can go over to somebody and stand over top of them and shoot them in the head 20 times until the clip empty. And then the guy land, brains all laid out on the ground, you know. Then the white man got to come and pick that mess up. That shows that you niggas, Negroes don't care. Now, what example that's setting for the other nations? You know, Esau looking at it like, damn, these niggers, they don't care for themselves. So why should I care for them? Then you want to march whenever a Trayvon Martin or something gets shot down by a white man. But Jake running around killing each other like it is going out of style. That's because a lot of these guys been raised by their mother. They ain't got no man. They ain't been around no manly spirit. They got a woman spirit on them. You know, a devilish, demon, wicked woman spirit on them. And they taking that anger out on the next black man that look just like them because they hate themselves. And the black woman, she teaches her sons to hate themselves just like she hate herself. Because she can't even wear her own damn hair. So that's a sign. That's a sign right there. That's self-hate right there. Whenever you can't walk outside without showing your hair, that's self-hate. So if a black woman, she hates her hair, what makes you think she gonna like you? You know? It's a damn shame, man. That's why this place gotta go. That's why the Most High going to destroy this fucking place. You fucking people, man. All right. Reading on, it says. All right, where I was at? Thou shalt, commit no murder. Thou shalt do no murder. And you Jakes are wicked as hell. That's all you do is murder your brothers. You know? Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Yeah, you Jake, that's all you do is steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness. Honor thy father and thy mother, and thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Right. So if you honor your brother, if that shows a reflection on yourself, you know. Just like the black woman, if she honor her black man, so-called Israelite man, that shows a reflection on how she cares for herself. The young man saith unto him, all these things have I kept from my youth up. What lack I yet? Yahawashah, listen up, brothers. Yahawashah said unto him, if thou wilt be perfect, go and sell that thou hast and give to the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come and follow me. Let's bring that back. Yahawashah said unto him, if thou wilt be perfect, go and sell that thou hast. In other words, he said, go sell all your belongings. You know, if you serious about this, because this guy was rich, he said, you know, go sell everything you got. And he said, and give it to the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come and follow him. Talking about Yahawashah. Yahawashah, he said, if everything you got, if go ahead and sell it, give it to the poor, and come follow me. Listen up, brother. Verse 22. But when the young man heard that saying, he went away sorrowful. He had great possessions. See? So he couldn't even do that. That might have been Floyd Mayweather in a reincarnation. You know? Because everybody got their lot. You know, that might have been Floyd. Yahweh Shah probably said, look, Floyd, he came up to Yahweh Shah. You know? It might not have, it could have been, you know, another Jake, you know, any old Jake. One of these. But he was, but you better believe that guy is back now. Whoever that was. But, you know, he came up to Yahweh Shah. Hey, I want part of the kingdom. Yahweh Shah could read your mind. So he knew the guy was rich. So he said, if you want to follow me, go sell everything you got and give, in other words, give everything you got away. And then come follow him. The dude couldn't do that. He couldn't give up his possessions. And that's why a lot of you, Jake, are going to be destroyed. You know, and a lot of you, Jake, are going to be destroyed because you can't even give up your certain habits you have. A lot of you, Jake, are going to be destroyed because you can't give up smoking weed. You know, because this is an example. This to show you that a lot of you, Jake, won't give up something for the Lord. A lot of you, Jake, can't stop smoking weed. A lot of you, Jake, you don't want to give up your riches. A lot of you, Jake, don't even want to show your face on camera, go out on the highways and byways to show your body a living sacrifice. You don't want to sacrifice. And that's what Yahweh Shah was basically saying. This was a sacrifice this young man could have did to, roll with Yahweh Shah. But he didn't want to make that sacrifice. And that's what, hey, brothers, that's what we're doing when we go on these highways and byways. We making our body a living sacrifice. That's the point. Okay, verse 23. And we're going to finish it. Then said Yahweh Shah unto his disciples, verily I say unto you that a rich man shall hardly enter into the kingdom of heaven. See? Reading on. And again I say unto you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of heaven. Yeah, because they don't want to make that sacrifice, you know. And a lot of guys have sold out to the Rothschild, the wicked elite, to Esau, sort of say. They don't want to make that sacrifice. When his disciples heard it, they were exceedingly amazed, saying, who then can be saved? In other words, they was like, wow, well, who can be saved? You know, and that needle. When they say the camel is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle for a rich man to enter the kingdom. The eye of a needle was an actual place over in ancient Israel. So whereas though it was hard, it wasn't an actual eye. You know, when you take a needle and look in the eye, it wasn't. That was an actual place. The actual place when you entered into it, it was shaped like a needle, the column was shaped like it, and oftentimes they would have to go through it, and it was hard for the camels to go through it because they had to go through it with a steady flow, and they were stumble when going through that small little area they call the eye of a needle. So that was an actual place. So, but still, you know, that was still hard for the camels to go through, you know. So Yahweh Shah was making that reference, you know, making an example, you know, because men, they don't want to sacrifice and give up things for the greater cause, you know. Reading on, it says, but when his disciples heard it, they were exceedingly amazed, saying, who then could be saved? But Yahweh Shah beheld them and said unto them, with men, this is impossible. With Yahweh, all things are possible. You see? So the Lord controls everything anyway, you know. Anything is possible with the Lord. All right, let's finish this. Let's start it. You know what? I'm a finish it off right here, brothers. And Lord willing, I make a another part to going in depth on in Matthew's. You know, that'll be, Lord willing, that'll be a part three to this. You know. And I'ma just start it off at Lord willing at verse 27. That'd be part three. You know. That way I can, you know, get everything together with and all that. But I hope this was edifying to the body, you know. I want to give all praise and honor and glory to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Till again, like I said again, Lord willing, it'll be in part three to going in depth on Matthew. And this time, this is part two, Matthew chapter 19. Till again, Shalom, brothers.